Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Camp Flood Media. Josh here. Today we'll be doing a ranking for the entire Wrong Turn franchise, starting from the 2003 original all the way to the 2021 reboot. We've got 7 movies to get through, so let's get into it. So coming in last place, we have Wrong Turn 6, Last Resort. I had a hard time picking whether or not I wanted Wrong Turn 5 or Wrong Turn 6 in last place because they're both pretty awful movies. However, when I really sat down and thought about it for a bit, this one ends up being even stupider than Wrong Turn 5 just because this guy learns that he just inherited this huge hotel from a family member that has passed away. So him and his friends go out to West Virginia to check it out. And after he gets there, he learns that the two owners are cannibals and they're his family members. And he ends up joining up with them and murdering all his friends. And it's just completely nonsensical by the time you get to the end of it. And also there's a sex scene where this girl is like raping a guy who she gave brain damage to. And it's just a terrible movie from start to end. Some of the kills are fun, but for the most part, the movie is just a complete mess and totally skippable, since technically this is an entire reboot of the franchise and none of the other movies matter to its continuity. If you like Wrong Turn 6, I'd actually like to hear from you because I don't know if there's any redeeming qualities for this movie. Coming in 6th place, we have Wrong Turn 5, Bloodlines. Now this one was almost my last place, but after I got editing the review for it a little bit more, I realized it wasn't quite as bad as I thought it was, but it's still pretty awful. Second worst, by far. The other movies above this are way more enjoyable. Not saying they're masterpieces, but they're a lot more enjoyable than this. The main sheriff character in this movie was just awful from start to finish. It felt like she could barely act half the time, and the group of friends that were in the movie were terrible. A bunch of unlikable idiots that pretty much all deserve to die. My main problem with this movie is that it's full of a bunch of elaborate deaths that don't really need to happen when you're watching a movie about mutant cannibal men who just rip people apart and eat them. Just kill them, rip them apart, don't take them from location to location and do different things to them and prolong the deaths and put them in pulley systems and do a bunch of dumb shit that doesn't need to happen because this movie is filled to the brim with dumb shit. That's it. In 5th place, we've got Wrong Turn 3, Left 4 Dead. Now, this one is probably the most boring in the franchise. It's not the worst, there's some good kills and the storyline is okay. It follows a prison bus crash where a bunch of prisoners get lost in the woods in West Virginia and they're being accompanied by a few cops and Three Finger and Three Toe slowly stalk them through the woods and murder them one by one. It's an okay movie, but the biggest problem I have with it is that it focuses on the prisoners more than the mutants, and I don't care about the prisoners at all. They're just doing a bunch of bullshit throughout the whole movie, arguing about money, and I don't care about that plot at all. It's mostly just bickering, and then it jumps over to a kill every now and then. So when they're actually doing the mutant stuff in the movie, it's pretty decent, but for the most part, it just follows a bland storyline, and you're just kind of waiting for it to end. However, one thing I do like about this movie is the surprise ending when the main character ends up actually being kind of a bad guy and he ends up getting killed for it. So I did like that twist ending. In 4th place, we've got Wrong Turn 4, Bloody Beginnings. And this is the first in the franchise ranking that I can say I actually enjoyed. I pretty much liked it from start to finish. The story follows this group of kids who are snowmobiling in West Virginia. They end up getting lost and come across a sanatorium. They go inside to keep warm, but little do they know, this is actually the home of Three Finger, Sawtooth, and One Eye, and as the movie goes on, they all get picked off one by one because their choice is either to stay and fight the mutants or go outside and freeze to death. I actually really enjoy most of the kills throughout this entire movie. There's only one really bad one where they pull this girl's head off and you can tell it's just the worst CGI in the world pretty much. But for the rest of the movie, I actually had a really fun time. And this is one I'll definitely be revisiting often as I rewatch the Wrong Turn franchise, which I can't really say for parts 5 and 6. I like that this one shows the origins of the mutants. You get to see them when they were kids and how brutal they were and what they did to themselves, and then it jumps forward to them being older and murdering all the new people who come by the sanatorium. I had a really fun time with this movie, and if you actually like the first couple Wrong Turn movies, you're definitely gonna like this one. So for my 3rd place choice, I had a really hard time choosing between this and my 2nd place choice. I ultimately ended up going with Wrong Turn 2 Dead End for 3rd place. I gotta say though, I think I enjoy watching this movie a little bit more than my 2nd place spot, but I think it's kind of undeniable that the 2nd place spot is a better movie. I really liked the reality TV show storyline in the second one. I liked how it set up this one girl, Mara, to be the main character. And then as the movie gets going, she just gets brutally killed right away. And you're like, what the hell? I also like that Ken Kersinger from Freddy vs. Jason is playing the main mutant in this one, Pa. He has such a physical force in this one, and when he's fighting all the other people, he's kicking their ass. Something I don't like, though, is that there's only a very little bit of Three Finger in this one. For being the main character pretty much from the first movie, he gets almost no screen time in this one and gets killed off pretty much right away. So I really wish they had a little bit more of him in this movie. But other than that, I really enjoyed the mutants that were in it, and I really enjoyed the storyline. Now, my number two spot might be a little bit controversial because I know some people weren't the biggest fans of this movie, but I've got to give the number two spot to the Wrong Turn reboot from 2021. I had such a great time watching it. It actually kind of blew me away. The acting is so much better than Wrong Turn 1 through 6, and the overall production of the actual movie is so much better than 2 through 6. It's not even close. All of the actors do a really great job in this movie. I honestly don't have a complaint about any of them. They did a great job reacting to the gruesome deaths that were going on in front of them and seeing all their friends die. If I had to make one or two complaints about the entire movie, my biggest complaint would be that the movie kind of comes to a complete halt halfway through when the father comes into the storyline. It just slows way down to focus on him for a bit, and I find that it really kind of kills the pacing of the movie at that point. My second complaint would be some of the kills could be a little bit gorier, but for what we got, I actually had a really great time, and I would totally watch a sequel to this right now. All right, guys, and here we are at number one. And could it be anything else but Wrong Turn from 2003? I have such a great time every time I watch this movie. If there was one movie from the entire franchise that I've watched like over and over again throughout the years, it's been Wrong Turn 2003. I actually hadn't even watched Wrong Turn 2 through 6 a second time until I was doing all my reviews for the channel. So that must say something about how good the first one is compared to 2 through 6. I really love Elijah Dushku in this movie. She's incredible in Buffy the Vampire Slayer as Faith, and she really kills it throughout this entire movie. The only problem I really have with her in the entire thing is towards the end, she becomes a little bit of a damsel in distress, but once she's freed, she ends up getting the bow and arrow and saving the main guy and kind of saving them both for the whole movie, so I don't really have any major complaints about this one. The actors themselves were pretty good, the kills were awesome, and the mutants themselves looked great, so I really don't have a major complaint about this movie at all. If there was one movie in the entire franchise that I would keep to watch and erase the other ones from history, it would no doubt be Wrong Turn 1 because it's the best in the franchise for me. All right, guys, so that was my ranking of the entire Wrong Turn franchise. I hope you had fun watching the video because I had fun making it. I know my placement of a few of the movies might be a little bit controversial, especially the Wrong Turn reboot because that was kind of a love it or you hate it movie. But I honestly had a good time with it, so I couldn't really put it any lower than that. The lowest I could have put it would be third place. But I honestly really have fun with the Wrong Turn movies. I have a completely different opinion on them after rewatching them again after all this time. Honestly, Wrong Turn 1, 2, 4, and the reboot are very solid and fun watches, so I definitely recommend watching them. Wrong Turn 3 is a bit boring, and then Wrong Turn 5 and 6 are completely stupid, so you can pretty much avoid them if you want. But if you're just looking for a scary good time with some mutant cannibals, definitely pop in Wrong Turn 1 and give that a watch, because that one is my favorite in the franchise, and honestly, I think it's the best one, even better than the reboot with its better acting and better movie production. Alright guys, so what did you think of the Wrong Turn franchise? Let me know your rankings from worst to best down below, because I'm really curious to see what you guys think of this whole franchise. Alright, until the next one, have a good one.